a stretch in my hamstrings, pushing a little bit further down into the mat, or in this case, onto my fingers. With each deep breath that I take, inhaling through my nose and releasing a little further into the stretch as I exhale. Walking my feet out onto my mat into down dog. Taking a few breaths here, exhaling, inhaling, deep breaths. I like to pedal my feet out, really get my calves stretched out. Going into three-legged dog, coming down and up into up dog. Ten push-ups. Then right into down dog. We will step with our left foot into warrior. Into warrior two. Reversing warrior. And flying through center. Into warrior at the back of the mat, reversing warrior, feeling it just a bit, stretching in center, we will then bind and take a step at the front of our mat, holding our balance on that right foot, transitioning our position into dancer and holding it there as long as we can. Pulling back up towards our center, that left leg, and taking a full lunge step back, settling into warrior, reversing, holding at the top, feeling that stretch, and flying through center. In warrior, reversing, holding at the top, feeling that stretch, and flying through center. Now coming into our bind, bringing that right leg up to the mat. All of our balance now on that right leg, transitioning our position into dancer, holding our balance there. Transitioning from dancer, lowering our body into chair pose.
I really like chair pose as it allows me to do a mini squat, but also lift up with my calves and allowing my body to feel this pose and stretch in a movement base. If you'd like to go lower, you can. Feeling in your quads, in your hamstrings, your calves, and your shins. Slowly lowering ourselves down to the mat to loosen up our lower back. I like to do spinal twists, fully allowing my lower back to feel the stretch by elongating my legs and or keeping them together. You can then transition into wheel pose.